Hello and welcome. This is Akriti Handa and you're watching Money Control. As voting to elect the 17th Lok Sabha has concluded, exit polls have given Prime Minister Narendra Modi a thumbs up, suggesting that the Bharatiya Janata Party will cross the majority mark on its own. According to News 18 Ipsos exit polls, the NDA is set to form the government with a clean sweep. On the other hand, the Congress's poor performance shows a dismal tally as compared to the BJP. The NDA is expected to win 336 seats, while with the BJP getting 276. The UPA, on the other hand, is lagging behind with just 82 seats, with the Congress managing only 46. Here's a quick wrap of some of the key states. Uttar Pradesh. As per the survey, the BJP is slated to get around 60 seats, a loss of 10 seats from the last election. Meanwhile, the SP-BSP combined are looking at 17 to 19 seats and the Congress hardly making gains of 1 to 2 seats. The BJP is set to retain its tally in Delhi, getting 6 to 7 seats with a slight chance that the Congress might win one seat. The AAP, however, seems to have failed to wrest even one seat despite it getting a sweeping majority in the 2015 assembly elections. 6 months back, the People's Mandate had put the Congress to power in the Hindi heartland states of Madhya Pradesh, Rajasthan and Chhattisgarh during the assembly polls. However, this time, the people seem to have changed their mind. The Ipsos exit polls have predicted a clean sweep for the BJP in all these states, with the party getting 24 to 27 seats in Madhya Pradesh, 22 to 23 in Rajasthan and 7 to 9 in Chhattisgarh. In Gujarat, the BJP seems to be repeating its 2014 landslide victory, getting at least 25 of the 26 seats. Meanwhile, in Maharashtra, the BJP Shiv Sena combined are expected to get 42 to 45 seats. On the other hand, the Congress NCP combined is expected to get a dismal 4 to 6 seats. In West Bengal, the high decibel contest between TMC Supremo Mamata Banerjee and the BJP, it seems that Mamata Didi has emerged winner, with the TMC getting 36 to 38 seats. Meanwhile, the BJP seems to have failed to break into Mamata's citadel and is expected to win only 3 to 5 seats. In Odisha, Naveen Patnaik's Biju Janata Dal is expected to get 12 to 14 seats, a slight loss from the 20 seats in the previous election. The BJP, on the other hand, seems to have eaten into the BJD's seat share, getting 6 to 8 seats, thanks to Prime Minister Modi's extensive campaigning in Odisha. In Telangana, K. Chandrasekhar Rao's TRS is expected to get 12 to 14 seats. Meanwhile, in Andhra Pradesh, it's a close call between Chandrababu Naidu's TDP and Jagan Mohan Reddy's YSR Congress, with the former getting 10 to 12 seats and the latter having a slight edge with 13 to 14 seats. These states highlight the significance of regional parties in these elections. In Tamil Nadu, the DMK Plus is set to gain 20 to 24 seats from nil in the previous election. Meanwhile, the AIADMK Plus has lost ground, getting only 14 to 16 seats. Kerala is an interesting state to watch as it is the only state which has a strong left foothold. The News 18 Ipsos exit polls have given 11 to 13 seats to the Left Democratic Front. Meanwhile, the UDF is expected to get 7 to 9 seats. So that's what the exit polls are saying. Now, all eyes will be on May 23rd when the final results will be declared. We'll see you soon, and for more views, news and updates, stay logged on to moneycontrol.com.